Imagine. Imagine a place that's different from anything you know. White, soft, billowy, warm lighting, slow, gentle music. In the corner, a tall tube with luminous bubbles. In another, sparkling stars. If you can imagine this place, you've probably visited a Snoezelen room. The word Snoezelen comes from two Dutch words, to sniff and to doze. In Israel, Snoezelen treatment is being used to help children with developmental disabilities, attention difficulties, and social problems. It is helping people suffering from pain, victims of terror, and other trauma. Adults with dementia are also benefiting. In general, people with sensory modulation problems seem to find it calming to be in the soft atmosphere of the Snoezelen room. Children who are usually passive respond with new interest in this room. Ori, a child with cortical blindness, cannot interpret what she sees. She tends to be withdrawn and makes no effort to look at things. She also avoids moving. Yet see how in the Snoezelen she notices the lights and perks up. She wants to feel. She wants to see. At the Sacred Heart home, parents find it easier to communicate with their severely disabled children in the Snoezelen. Iris says that it's easier to bring her other daughter to the Snoezelen. There, she can play and have a good time. Since this facility was created, many parents who used to avoid coming to see their children now feel better about visiting. In the accepting atmosphere, they find it easier. One of the most interesting discoveries we have made is that being in the Snoezelen offers new pathways to communicating with people with Alzheimer's, people who haven't talked or interacted for years. Herzl says he hasn't been able to engage his mother's attention for a long time. Here he is with Maleka, his mother, and her caregiver in the Snoezelen. Maleka's therapy includes massage, smelling a variety of pleasant scents, the visual stimulation of lights and moving patterns. It's an intimate setting where she is the centre of attention. Some 15 minutes into the session, we can already see a difference in Maleka's behaviour. She seems truly to be enjoying herself. Imagine Herzl's delight as his mother looks at him, touches him, and even begins to sing. Perhaps it's the lights, the colour. Perhaps it's a special attention that unlocks Maleka. What is it about the Snoezelen that has this effect? While sensory stimulation is essential, we know the magic only happens within the context of a special relationship. We've come to call this an enabling relationship. Diana has Rett syndrome, which affects her development in every way. She waves her hands in stereotypical fashion and doesn't use them functionally. She is encouraged to touch, to hold, to see, and to listen. Michelle Shapiro has pioneered Snoezelen in Israel. Under her direction, Beatizia Shapiro is leading the development of Snoezelen training. Therapists from diverse disciplines are now using the method to help children and adults with special needs. Today, there are over 160 Snoezelen in Israel. Michelle sits closely next to Diana. She reaches out to her. She calls her name. Diana. Diana. She wonders whether Diana even hears her. At first, she seems to hardly notice. The development of Snoezelen has been nothing short of stunning. What started as a simple exploration has developed into a model of treatment. Today, Snoezelen has its own identity and its assumptions are finding support in research. The enabling orientation is impacting on the relationship between therapist and client far and above what happens in the Snoezelen room, improving understanding, deepening communication, and stimulating new pathways in the mind.